Hello everyone and welcome to this session of Fashion Photography. I'm Rohan and I have with me Vinay, my colleague from the Nikon India technical team. Hi Vinay.
Hello Rohan.
Vinay, we are here today to talk about fashion photography.
Right.
So let me ask you, what does fashion photography mean to you?
Yes, fashion photography actually excites us a lot. It's all about glamorous models, it's about too much of lights and so much of makeup and yes, exotic locations.
Yes, that word fashion does bring all those thoughts to our mind. But Vinay, let me tell you, fashion photography is a genre of photography which is very open to interpretation and extremely creative. But you know, there's a lot of behind the scenes that goes on, a lot of homework that happens. You know, there's a lot of planning in which you have selection of models, selection of the right costume, could be makeup, styling. So a whole lot of research work goes into before you actually go ahead and execute a shoot. Right. So Vinay, for the better understanding of our viewers, why don't we take them outdoors on an actual live shoot location?
Sure.
I'm very excited about today's shoot. First time I'm shooting in a desert.
The climate is like, it's so cold and everything is like, the atmosphere is so hot and people are getting ready. And
this is different, as in we are going to do our shoot in the sand dunes. It's for a brand like Nikon, so I'm really chilled out and I'm looking forward to it.
So here we are on an outdoor location for our fashion photography episode. It's a beautiful morning, it's 8 a.m. Sun is at a very nice angle. As you can see, we are in between sand dunes. This is Jaisalmer, Rajasthan, and there's a beautiful sky behind us. Today, to demonstrate the outdoor fashion photography section of our fashion photography episode, what we are doing is, if you can see at the back, there are a few models. We've gotten some professionals to help us make this episode and to demonstrate how you can get amazing high fashion images. Vinay, as you see that, you know, the sand dunes and the skies alone make a very, you know, monotonous or a barren landscape. To add a bit of splash of colors in between, what we've done is we are using a few props. We've got our models draped in some really vibrant colors that bring out the character of this place. So the gear we're using today are D750 camera and a 7200 lens. And Vinay here has?
I have an 810 and a 24-70. I'm thinking of taking some wide angle shots.
So great. What I'll be doing is I'll be taking shots with the 70 to 200mm lens so that I can isolate the subject from the background. Also, since it's a nice, bright, sunny day, we are using the direct sunlight white balance. Our cameras are on ISO 100 and we'll be choosing the shutter speed and aperture, aperture about f8 to f11, and the shutter speed would depend upon the movement as we pose the models, as we direct the models.
So add to that, we'll be using a picture control standard and let's try to increase the clarity of it. And if at all you reduce it completely, it becomes more dreamy kind of a thing. So it becomes more effective. So let's try to shoot a picture with complete clarity and let's try to reduce it completely.
Another important tip, like we always share during our episodes, I'd like to share with our viewers is that before you think or before you execute a shoot, it's always good to do a little bit of homework. Look at some good reference images, some photographers that you follow, or you know, some fashion magazines. Since we are doing a fashion shoot, we did also refer a few fashion magazines. This just brings and gives you references in your mind to bring out your creativity and you know, to explore different angles, you know, just to add to your creative skill to bring out amazing images. So that's all for now, and we'll head towards the shoot and let's see how it goes today. Ready? Yeah, go for it. Very nice, very nice. Move your hand a little bit. Yeah. Little ahead, little ahead. Try a few more of those. Yeah, nice. Come a little more into the sun. Yeah, perfect. Yeah, that's nice. That's nice. The headgear is a little too much in, you know, on the forehead. I want it slightly pulled back, slightly. Keep going, keep going. Yeah, that's nice. Keep moving, we'll keep shooting, okay? So Vinay, I think we had a great shoot this morning.
Yes, we did.
We tried different angles, we tried different props.
Correct.
And the beautiful morning light, we made the most of it. And now as you see that the light's gone up, you know, the sun's gone up into the sky and it's become a little harsh. I think we'll have to give it a little break and shoot again from say about 3 or 4 in the afternoon when the light is more angular and more suitable for this kind of a fashion shoot outdoors. Our second location in Jaisalmer, a tourist spot called Kuldhara. Today, to demonstrate fashion photography, we have again a model with us. If you see in the background, we have Himakshi. As you see in the background, there's a house, there's this structure that we'll be using to do our fashion shoot today. The light is beautiful, but since we have a very short window of time to demonstrate and take beautiful pictures, let us, without further ado, go ahead and take some pictures and demonstrate how this is done. Himakshi, into the camera. Just for 1 second, open your eyes, okay? So here, as you can see, my colleague Vinay is trying to take some shots of Himakshi here. If you look, the sunlight is very nicely falling onto the model. At this time, since it's fashion photography also deals a little with directing your model. Telling her how to pose, how to face into the light, you know, the body posture. All these things are very important to keep in mind while doing fashion photography. So here I'd like to share a tip with everyone. In conditions like this, brightly lit conditions like this, and especially when, you know, your subject, model, or people that you're shooting are wearing white color, whereas it reflects back a lot of light, you should take care of your highlights. One should always expose for the highlights, because once you have details in your highlights, the details in your shadow and, you know, the darker areas of your image can still be taken care of in the post. But one should always try and get the highlights right. The sun's setting down, there's a beautiful golden light. So what we are trying to do here is we have Pera model stand against the sun so that the sun provides a nice rim lighting in the hair, and we are using a reflector which my colleague Vinay is handling, and through the reflector we are bouncing back light onto the model's face. So I'd really like to share a tip here that in conditions like this where you use natural resources like the sun to your advantage, you can place the model against the sun, use it as a beautiful hair light. And with a reflector, maybe if you do not have something like this, you could even use a foam core or a thermocol board and reflect light back onto the model's face. doing so, you can use the sun for a nice hair light and get a very beautiful portrait in this beautiful lighting. You know, the sun is going down really fast and I want to make the most of this light. So what we're going to do is we're going to take some more beautiful shots with Himakshi here and we'll review them with you in the studio. Here we are back in the studio after this amazing outdoor shoot at Jaisalmer. Right. You know, the whole experience of shooting the rising sun, you know, the golden sunsets, shooting on the sand dunes, it was just an amazing experience.
Right, Rohan, it was an amazing experience. And I'm pretty sure we have gotten amazing images as well. And it was not just about us being getting up early and shooting. It was also about the efforts of stylists who made our models look more glamorous. And not to forget about the art department. The sets what they had put on the sand dunes were like really amazing. Everything put together created such glamorous images.
So Vinay very rightly said, you know, such high fashion glamour shoots at such a large scale are just not one person's job. And our team fared really well and, you know, because of their help, we were able to get some great shots. So Vinay, through this, we have been able to demonstrate for our viewers how an outdoor high fashion shoot can be executed. But, you know, Vinay, in the outdoors, light is something that is not under our control, you know, and we have to be at the mercy of nature and different times of the day to get the light that we need. And light is one major element of photography, or actually is the element of photography. Let us take our viewers inside a studio and talk about, you know, lighting setups or lighting styles, which will help them understand lighting indoors to control it better for, you know, for portraits or for fashion photography, so that they can make the most of this genre.
Yes, let's get into the studio and we'll try to demonstrate all the different kinds of lighting which we have.
Sure. Yeah. So we've already shot outdoors and now today we are here in the studio to talk about, you know, lighting and doing fashion photography in a more controlled environment. But inside the studio we have the liberty where the light is in our control.
Right.
So to demonstrate the same, we have the beautiful Pia again with us. And she'll be helping us demonstrate a few lighting styles. So Vinay, why don't you help us understand this in a better way?
Yes, Rohan. In this particular light, we can see we have two LED lights which have been placed in such a way that Pia's face is equally lit from both the sides. And we are not able to see any kind of shadow on her face. And every detail of her face is very clear. And this we call it as flat lighting because it is flat. Okay, Rohan, let's take a picture and check it out, how it looks.
Sure, Pia, if I could just ask you to move a little bit towards the light and then face back towards the camera.
Yeah.
Okay. So this gives a nice posture and a nice, you know, curve to the body and makes the model look more beautiful.
Right.
Smile. Okay. So Rohan, this is a picture which we just got.
Yeah, it's very nice, equally lit. And you know, this completely demonstrates how flat lighting actually produces an image.
Right.
So Vinay, let's talk about our next style of lighting called broad lighting.
Right. We'll do one thing, Rohan. We'll just switch off this particular light and we'll have this light to be on. Can we have the light, please? Yeah.
This one?
Yes.
Perfect. So I think where Pia is sitting right now is actually, by just switching on this light, we've created broad light.
That's right. So you can see 80% of her face has been lit and 20% is towards the shadow.
Yes, and when would you use such kind of a light?
When we have a thin, lean model or something, when we want to create a little bit of weight on our face.
Okay, so people with narrow faces or
right.
Slim people, and if you want to, you know, just make them look a little bit chubbier,
right.
That is when you can use broad lighting.
Right.
Okay, great. Can we just take a picture?
Sure.
Yeah, if I could just have you move slightly into the, yeah, just there. Okay. Little back towards me. So when I'm taking it one step forward from broad lighting, I think short lighting is just the opposite of broad lighting.
Right, right.
So to demonstrate that, I think we should again shut off this light and turn that light back on. Pia, can we have you move back face towards the light? So like we saw in broad lighting that the 80% of the face was lit and 20% was in shadow. And the brightly lit side of the face was facing towards the camera.
Yeah.
So in short lighting, since it's absolutely the opposite, mm-hmm. so the lit side, the 80% of the lit side of the face is facing away from the camera, right. and the shadow side of the face is pointing towards the camera.
Correct.
So this kind of lighting setup, I think we should use, since it's just the opposite, mm-hmm. for people who are chubby and making them look slimmer.
Right.
Right. Great. Why don't we take a picture?
Okay. So this is the picture which we have got.
Very nice.
Very nice.
So Vinay, if we'd like to give a little artistic or, you know, a classic look to our pictures, mm-hmm. we can use Rembrandt's style of lighting.
Right. Yeah.
Now Rembrandt, as the artist, he used this style of lighting in his portraits while he used to paint. Mm-hmm. So in this style of lighting, basically what happens is the light, as you can see in the setup, is placed at a slightly elevated and placed at a 45 degree angle from our subject. Mm-hmm. And the way the light falls on the subject's face, the shadow from the nose kind of extends up to the upper lip and forms a triangle of light under the eye.
That looks very beautiful.
Which kind of makes our subject or our model look more beautiful.
Right.
So that is the Rembrandt style of lighting, and we can use it to bring out, you know, beauty, character, and make the images look a little warm.
Correct.
Yeah. So why don't we take a picture for a review?
Okay. This is a perfect lighting for Rembrandt. And Rohan, if you just check this out, in this particular picture, this shadow side of the face, the eye on the shadow side of the face is getting a catch light. And that is also one of the very important thing when we are doing a Rembrandt.
Okay, so this is one important tip, like Vinay shared, we have to keep that in mind, that the eye on the shadow side should get a little bit of a catch light.
Right.
That, you know, makes the image more engaging. So Vinay, let's talk about our final lighting setup for this session,
sure.
which is butterfly lighting. Mm-hmm. So just to set up for that, why don't we switch off this light and switch on this light behind. So Vinay, for our viewers, why don't you explain the setup?
Sure, Ron. If you can see this, we have the model, the camera, as well as the light. Everything is in the same line. And by what we have done for the light, we have just raised it up so that we get a nose shadow a little bit down. So by doing this, it forms a butterfly shape. And this is a very beautiful light, which is used to, you can call it as a beauty light also, to bring out the beauty of the model.
Okay, so yes, I can see that, you know, by raising the light up and pointing it down, there's a very fine shadow on the upper lip that is being formed by the nose. So this shadow is probably referred to as butterfly lighting.
Very right.
I think, Vinay, this kind of lighting can be used to bring out, like you said, beauty, mm-hmm. glamour, or can also be used for some, you know, elderly people to make them look more glamorous or more young or more vibrant. Mm-hmm. So why don't we take a picture for our review?
Sure.
Okay. So here you go. We have this picture. Looks beautiful.
Beautiful lighting. Right. Yes. This kind of lighting just accentuates the, you know, the features, brings out the skin and makes the, you know, whomever you're shooting, either it's your model or family member or someone, more glamorous and looks very nice. So thanks, Pia, for helping us demonstrate all these lighting styles. For our viewers, I'd like to say that you must have noticed that we've used just one light during this whole exercise of, you know, different lighting styles. Why we've done that is because, you know, our psyche, our human eyes, we as humans are used to only one light source, which is the sun. So most of the pictures that we like or, you know, instantly like when we see them is majorly lit by one light source. So by using just one light source, you can do so many styles by just placing your model or your light source in a certain direction and get different effects in your images. Mm-hmm. So I hope this session is very helpful for you, and you will try all these lighting styles in studio or by using different modes or types of light for lighting your portraits. So Vinay, since we've completed both our outdoor and indoor shoots, why don't we go ahead and review some images?
Sure.
So let's look at a few images from our outdoor shoot. You know, here in our outdoor shoot, our main motive was to showcase high fashion. You know, costumes, models, the styling, you know, the makeup, all against the, you know, this beautiful environment, the sand dunes, in different lighting conditions, early mornings, late, during sunsets. So we were able to get some really nice images against this backdrop and, tell our viewers how a high fashion shoot can be executed on an outdoor location.
Rightly said, Rohan. We had an amazing shoot outdoor, and yes, indoor is also very important, because in indoor we spoke about a lot of different kinds of lighting, whether it is Rembrandt or split lighting or even the butterfly lighting, the beautiful light. And this goes to all our viewers who are like trying to experiment or try to want to pursue fashion photography or portrait photography, and lighting is the most important.
Yes, lighting does play a major role in all sorts of photography, actually.
Yeah.
So Vinay, I think we were able to share some helpful tips for our viewers and for aspiring portrait or fashion photographers. That is all from this session, and we'll be back with more interesting sessions. Until then, these are your Nikon buddies, Rohan and Vinay, signing off.